Recently, a client was telling me about how revolutionary Power Query is for cleaning up all of their data. They were also very excited to tell me about a neat trick they learned that makes Excel Power Query even better. In a minute, I'm going to tell you about what that neat trick is, how you can utilize it, and why you should actually avoid using it 99% of the time. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. In my Excel Power Query course, I talk about how you can use Power Query to link a data file, transform it, and save all of the steps that can be rerun with a click of a refresh button, with no VBA or even Excel formulas required. The key and most important point I wanted to emphasize here is a link to a data file. See, the way that Excel is normally used is that files contain both the data and the formulas to process that data. The data stored in an Excel file is often a process data set that has been manipulated from the original source data. Often, there is no way to get back to the source data or easily replicate your process unless you also save down a completely untouched copy of your file and take note of all your process steps to be repeated. By making the data separate from the processing logic, we have the benefit of always having a pure copy of our source data and a reusable set of processing logic that can easily be applied to any new data set that comes in. This is the best practice and the secret that enables you to reuse your Power Query processes when your data gets updated and needs to be refreshed. That means if you run a regular process, you can just drop the file in a folder and hit the refresh button. Because the original data is separate from the processing steps, a link is formed between the two files to enable the Power Query automation. All this means is that your Excel file contains a pointer to where the source data is located. This is what I refer to as linking. And the process actually happens automatically anytime you use Power Query to get data from an external file. This process is also known as importing your data, which is the recommended alternative to directly opening it. Even if you think you're doing a quick one-off job, there are a number of good reasons why you should import your data instead of directly opening it. First of all, how many times have you started working on a file, only to realize that someone left off a field or sent you an out-of-date copy? You've been working on the file for an hour, and now you need to redo all of your work because the person needed to resend the file. If you had imported instead of opening it, you could just update the dataset and avoid any copy, paste, and rework. Secondly, and probably the most important reason why to import, is that Excel has a lot of autocorrections. Probably most notably is text getting converted to numbers, meaning that you lose leading zeros, and dates getting imported incorrectly. For example, US dates opened on a European system will incorrectly swap the day and month, where possible, and convert all of the other dates to text, which are not usable in date calculations. The same is true of European to US conversions as well. I can't overemphasize how much data is corrupted and reported incorrectly every day because of these very common issues. Simply opening an Excel file and hitting the save as, even if you have not touched a thing, is enough to corrupt the file. This is why you should always download a file and move it to the correct folder without opening it through Excel. If you do open the Excel file, whatever you do, do not hit the save button. Close the file and move it instead. Once you move the file, you can import it through Power Query, which will eliminate any issues caused by Excel autocorrection. Thirdly, if you have a lot of data, it's possible to reduce the size of your data while simultaneously increasing performance and processing capacity by importing your data to places other than worksheets. File sizes can be as much as 40 times smaller and processing speeds hundreds of times higher. For most people, worksheets are the only place they know to store data. Worksheets give Excel its familiar look and feel, but are actually the least efficient way to store and process larger amounts of data. reduced file size and calculation performance can be achieved by simply importing the data directly to the Pivot cache, or even better, Power Pivot data model. Finally, the fourth reason why you should always link using Power Query is that it doesn't really take any extra time. Basically, you just need to hit the import button instead of the open button. I know that everyone, including myself, is in the habit of just opening files. So when you have to close down the file and redo the process, it feels like a bit of a hassle and is mentally uncomfortable because you have simply been opening files for as long as you can remember. Really, this is the shortest part of the process though. And wouldn't you rather reopen your file through an import than redo all of your work when the underlying file changes? So what is the neat Power Query trick that my client discovered? What my client discovered was that you can also use Power Query on data that is already in your spreadsheet without needing to import it. Now, there's definitely a whole ton of powerful transformations you can do on your data using this method. However, in my opinion, you lose 80% of the real benefit of Power Query by not linking your data. By not linking, you won't be able to refresh data. Excel autocorrect can corrupt your data before you've started working on it, and you won't be able to take advantage of smaller file sizes and improved performance by utilizing Pivot Cache or Power Pivot. Other trainer friends of mine who also teach Power Query will often use this trick, as it somewhat streamlines the process and the training of the Power Query feature in focus. However, this is one point I have to disagree with, as the benefit of doing this correctly far outweighs the shortcut. It will also ensure that the habits you form now will be in line with the practices you have to use in a more professional data workflow. This is why I would avoid this trick 99% of the time. So what is the 1% of the time when I would use this trick? When building models, you have to be able to take drivers and inputs into your calculations. Normally, you would use more traditional Excel formulas and techniques, or move to a tool like R to build these models. The reason for this is that traditional Excel formulas update automatically when cell values change. It's this feature that provides interactivity, but at the same time makes spreadsheets incredibly slow at processing larger datasets when a lot of formulas involved. A workaround for this is to link Power Query to your input driver tables, which is already in your spreadsheet. This enables you to batch all your transformations and avoid large number of Excel formulas. In practice though, a lot of these models would simply be easier to build in R. If you'd like to get a free data analytics training covering the best ways to use Excel and R with downloadable examples which you can reuse for your own work, head over to www.datastrategywithjonathan.com to claim your free course. If you found this video helpful, please give a thumbs up. It really helps out a lot to keep the channel going. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.